we issued a suspension with respect to last Sunday's events in the televised game between L.A. and Oklahoma City. And I can tell you that it's some combination of art and science. We look at previous penalties. We look at who's involved in the altercation. We do take into account the seriousness of the injury and a variety of other whatever else is in the atmosphere, and then it just becomes my job to decide what it should be. And if I were looking inside from without, I would agree with everyone who has an opinion. But at the end of the day, it's my job to make the decision and then move on, and hopefully we can. With that, we'd be happy to take any questions.
Commissioner, you said you took into account the seriousness of James Harden's injury. How concerned were you that Meta World Peace might return before James? Or did that enter into your thinking for the length of the suspension?
I can't really say that I focused on it exactly that way. We have reason to believe that James will be available for the playoffs, and we hope he will be. And we were very thankful that his injury was not more serious than it was. That's the extent of the consideration.
If you could just expand on your statement yesterday on how you arrived at the number of games for the suspension yesterday, why seven, if you could, as best you can describe for us, you came to that conclusion?
Actually, I wish I could, but I can't, because you're asking me, well, why not six? Well, that's interesting. Why not eight? Could have been.
No, I'm just asking why seven.
In light of all of the considerations and in light of past suspensions and fitting it in someplace, seven seemed to be about the right number. And with full knowledge that if seven is okay, then six or eight probably could have been justified the same way, and it's my job to say seven. And I think the seven was larger than some people might have thought from just an elbow, and I think that in many cases people who thought that this was so horrible that it should result in a lifetime ban, but at the end of the day I have to close the door and say, okay, what's justice here and what's fairness here? And I came up with seven.
David, I'm curious, as you weighed the seven, was there any emphasis put on that six was going to be in the playoffs, and was that given any special consideration as having extra weight because it was the playoffs, or would it have been seven games if this was January, February, the same as if it's one in the regular season and six in the playoffs?
It's a fair question, and I think that we knew that seven at this time of year was even more severe than it would have been during the regular season, that only one game was going to be lost in the regular season, and basically he would be out for most, if not all, of the first round. And yes, Scott, that did factor into it. I can't tell you that it was done with a precise equation, but it certainly was something that I was well aware of.
Yeah, hi, David. I just want to, hate to do it, but I want to go back to the suspension one more time just to clarify. When you were talking about looking at the previous things and who's involved, how much did that affect the number? If this was not, Ron Artest and this was any other player on the floor, we took in, four games versus seven. How much did this weigh in the past?
Just a minute. Let me check my slide rule, Brian. I'm going to do the calibration as I sit here. Oh, okay. Yes, if it were somebody else, it would have been probably, it shows here 6.2, so I'll round it down to 6. Obviously, all of those things are considered. And in fact, if it had been somebody who got tangled up and threw an errant elbow, would that have been different than this? You bet it would have been. And so, you know, despite my, you know, my joke about it, it's really very serious stuff. And it does take into account the fact that the perpetrator is who he is and has the record that he has. And this called for, in our view, a very stiff penalty. And we think that 7 games, which only includes one regular season game, is such a stiff penalty.
David, hello.
Hi, Fran.
Just again, we'll go back to that dead horse again. You said in your last response about the Metal World Peace incident, you said if in fact it had been somebody tangled up and threw an errant elbow, it might have been a different penalty. Does that mean that you believe it was intentionally thrown?
I believe that it was recklessly thrown. And I believe that in looking at the replays again and again, that he should have known that James was up against him. And some would argue that he had to have known, but I can't be in his mind at that moment or what was overriding what. But the fact was, under all the circumstances, it was reckless and dangerous.
Yes, Commissioner. The Meta World Peace Incident may lend to questions about the league's mental health policies. And would you consider any increases in that policy to have maybe players examined in situations where it seemed like Meta World Peace might have lost it for a minute or might have just lost control? Is that something that concerns you?
I actually don't even want to go into that because that would be a private discussion among us, the union, and the potential players or some way to say patients involved. Suffice it to say, it's a subject that we are continually evaluating. But we're actually, I think that in some ways, the incident brings into bold relief the progress that we have made over the years. If you may recall, Gary, we used to have players throwing punches, players coming off the bench, all kinds of things that it is now clear will subject players to suspension. And I don't want to sort of go too far into the mind of the here, just to suffice it to say that I considered it to be reckless and dangerous. It had to be dealt with the way we dealt with it.
Hi, David. Question in regards to the deal with your suspension on Meta. Is the concern that's kind of arisen this past year, probably the last 2 years, with concussions and, you know, kind of all the new policies that are being put in and the emphasis, not only with his case, but in, you know, future instances where you judge a flagrant foul, does that kind of factor in to decision making as well in terms of being really proactive with emphasizing the players about headshots?
We know he had a concussion here, and that was just his injury. But frankly, in a wholly separate way, we have begun to focus on these entire concussion protocols. The number of concussions diagnosed is up this year. Whether they're actually up or we're diagnosing more, I can't tell you because we didn't have the same uniform standards for all teams. It is an emphasis of ours. It will remain an increased emphasis, just like our echocardiogram heart exams for all players every year, and we're continually looking for ways to, you know, guarantee the health and safety of our players. I can't say that it was it didn't relate to the policy of the discussions, Mike. It was really more that was the injury, and that's a serious and concerning injury. But it didn't relate back to that policy in any other than that way.